Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's discuss diastereomers. What is a diastereomer? Well, diastereomers are a type of stereoisomer. There are two types of stereoisomers. There are enantiomers and diastereomers. And diastereomers are distinguished by the fact that two molecules, if we're trying to determine if they're diastereomers, A, they are non-superimposable. B, they need to be non-mirror images. And of course, we need to make sure that they're truly potential stereoisomers. They have to have the same molecular formula, they have to have the same connectivity, and only differ by the geometry of their connections between atoms. But if they meet those criteria, and they're non-superimposable, and they are non-mirror images, these are diastereomers. So we have four molecules on the screen. The one in the upper left of the four molecules is a molecule that now has two stereocenters. And to talk about diastereomers, you almost always need to have two stereocenters. Not exclusively, but almost always. So if we wanted to see what the enantiomer would be for the structure, for enantiomers, to draw an enantiomer, a quick shortcut is simply to invert all your stereocenters. So we have two stereocenters. Let's reverse the bromine and the hydrogen, which we've done here, the bromine and the hydrogen. That converts our R stereocenter to the S stereocenter. And then on the other stereocenter, let's flip-flop the hydrogen and fluorine. That gets us to here, and it goes from S to R. These would be enantiomers. Okay, well, what happens if we flip at least one of our stereocenters, but not all of our stereocenters? Well, that's what this lower left structure is for. We've reversed our hydrogen and our bromine, but left the fluorine and hydrogen the same. And that reverses this stereocenter, the R, to become S, but the S stereocenter with fluorine remains S. Well, now we've reversed at least one stereocenter, but not all. These are diastereomers of each other. And when I say that, what I mean is they're non-superimposable, they're not the same molecule, and they are not mirror images of each other. They are diastereomers. Now, there's one stereoisomer that we haven't drawn. It's the RR form. And so I'm not going to walk through all the swapping things, but this is the RR form. And you should be able to look at any of these structures and say, oh, yes, that's RR because you reversed groups or didn't reverse groups. So there are four total stereoisomers for this structure. As it turns out, the total number of stereoisomers on the lower right is equal to 2 to the n power. And n is equal to the number of stereocenters. So in this case, we have 2 to the second power, and that tells us that we should have likely four stereoisomers. There are exceptions to this, but in general, it's 2 to the n power, number of stereocenters. And we've drawn all four of those stereoisomers. These two are enantiomers because we reverse the stereocenters. R to S becomes S to R, and the lower line, S to S goes R to R, so those are enantiomers. As it turns out, these are diastereomers. Any of these vertical relationships are diastereomers and crisscrossing diagonally. So this molecule in the upper right has one enantiomeric relationship. That's this structure. Oh, I'm sorry, in the upper left. As we go to the right, that's its one enantiomer, and it has two molecules to which it's a diastereomer. Every molecule will have only one enantiomer and potentially multiple diastereomers. So let's say we have four stereocenters, 2 to the 4th, potentially 16 stereoisomers. If we pulled one molecule out of there, there would be one enantiomer to that molecule. And that one molecule would have 14 diastereomers. So you can have lots of diastereomeric relationships, only one enantiomer. And so that's what a diastereomer is. It's a non-superimposable, non-mirror image.